This is really rumoured after when Crash had his own remake, but it's great it's finally announced that Spyro also getting a remake also, even though that Spyro in general had what somewhat games as it is, but it's nice that it's gone back to its own roots, even though that Activision owns, you know, Spyro and Crash, so it makes sense to do a remake of Spyro also. Let alone there will be a time exclusive like Crash did, and so it will be on both platforms than it is the Nintendo Switch to Spyro as it is. Then it is, I'm more into Crash back into my PlayStation 1 days, but it's nice that, you know, these games in general are coming out. Oh, hey Crash. Oh, don't worry about you, Crash. I will be getting you on the Xbox One this year. Then it is Spyro I'll be planning to get in September also. But yeah, don't worry, Crash, I still love you either way back in my PlayStation 1 days.
It's a vlog.
Again, I'd like to say it's nice that Activision are doing a remake, remaster of Spyro as it is. And it makes sense because, you know, Activision can own both the properties for Crash and Spyro. Then it is the whole Crash predicament, you know, last year as it is, with, you know, being a time exclusive on PlayStation. Because funny which, yesterday when Spyro was announced, and not only it's going to come out on Xbox One and PlayStation 4, but not on the Switch, sadly, for some odd reason. There was a bit of confusion after the announcement yesterday, but I don't know if it's going to come on Nintendo Switch as is, because Crash has come on the Nintendo Switch. There's the Xbox One version of Crash and all that. But one of these days, Activision, though, where's my Black Ops 4 for Switch as it is? But despite all ports as it is, I'm sure they'll might clear it up at E3 this year, despite certain ports as it is. But other than that, though, it's nice that we're getting certain retro games, a different story. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Walker from DT Films. It's a vlog. Just for a quick mention, I got a slight update on my Windows camera because I got like more settings to do with the lens than it is and the brightness in general. So I tried to tinker with the settings to make sure it's matching with this and that. But I thought I'd quickly mention in case I get a slight hiccup on my camera as it is. And even though, just for quickly mention, I don't know if you may notice, I kind of rearranged, not seeing a few things, because I just slightly moved my rug, because every time I sit on the sofa, my rug goes a bit back, and it's been going back. I don't know if you notice in some other videos, but sometimes when I'm playing video games on the sofa, and jump on the sofa, it moves a bit back. Anyways, I thought I'd mention about that just quite briefly. Anyways, what videos I did this past week in general, and just did the one particular video this past 1 week. Despite it's been a new month recently, I should say, but yeah, I did a new month of video for you guys. I know you enjoyed this month's month of video, even though it's a slight, nothing different. I was planning to do a certain video about it, despite my PC alone can't perform certain tiles as it is. I mentioned about my month of video, even though my number one out of that video. It was quite funny because Adrian was trying to explain to me, he's like, why did you choose this game as number one? Does it perform very well on your PC? Well, it's just, I had a slight confusion regarding that when Adrian told me about that. But I just want to briefly mention for those that did watch it, and the reason why I chose that game as number one, despite the settings on my PC as is, because I had to turn the settings very low to be able to run on my PC that is under 20 frames per second. It's all a different story. But at least it runs in a way, and there's just reasons why I chose it for number one, despite other tiles like Wither Pit, but it's just my PC performance alone and the reasons why I chose it. But nonetheless, despite that though, it was nice to do that certain month video, then it's playing whatever month videos for months to come. It's all a different story. But other than that though, yeah, that's the kind of video that I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I want to share you guys something that happened quite recently, even though when it was just last weekend as it is, despite my last vlog that I would have mentioned, but I don't want to mention too much. I would rather mention this vlog than is my last vlog. But I mentioned on my last vlog quite briefly about certain things, even though loads of things have been putting me off last week in general. But despite that though, this vlog in general, I just want to mention in regards on something that recently happened in the UK in general, because certain stores around the UK have been recently closed down, and there's a certain store in my local area, is a different thing, even though all those other particular stores in my local area have been shutting down. It's all a different story, but a certain store that I loved dearly for the past few years, despite the staff in general that have been connecting quite good and despite my social problems there is. But other than that, though, yes, Granger Games has recently shut down. Despite when I heard about the rumours just last weekend about certain stores shutting down, well, certain Granger Games stores shutting down, and I didn't think it would affect me quicker than expected, which is really, really a shame, really. It's mainly to do with the company, then its financial problems, whole different story. Which, just while I briefly mention, my theory of why is that happened. Because of, the Be More Geek range, I should say, with Grange Games that they have, and for the past, last year, a few years now, I think it was last year in general, they had the Be More Geek range side of things when it comes to Grange Games. And then, I guess Grange Games, the company, kind of invested number of, geeky items, I should say, because there's, loads of geeky merch in my Grange Games, all different stories. So it makes sense why in Grange Games invested, loads of geeky stuff. And I get most people, even I would love to afford, a Iron Man helmet, or the Master Sword, or a Highland Shield, or any sort of thing that my local Grange Games had. But not much people can somewhat afford it, so to say. And I guess that's the reasons why financial problems in general, which makes sense why Granger Games and all the other Granger Games in general had to shut down. That's my theory and take it on reasons. But that's my theory in general. But it's just a shame, really, that all my, well, not saying my Granger Games, but everyone else's Granger Games has been gone for the past week, I should say, because it only just happened just last weekend when I heard about the rumours at first. But again, like I said, I didn't think it will affect my Granger Games as it is. Even though I haven't been to town much lately, it's all different story. Despite I only been to town last week on Wednesday, because I was in town last Wednesday and I had to quick nip into my local Granger Games despite the rumours that I've been hearing. And knowing me, I can interact with the staff in general, and they just has had to quit hi to me and not seeing how I was doing. Even though that I haven't been to town since last Wednesday, and I haven't been to town on Saturday or Monday, my usual routines when I visit town, and because of the weather, mostly. And it's just, I'm visiting lately, and this week, when I've been to my local Granger Games this week on Wednesday, when I got a chance to visit town, it just closed down, which is really, really a bit of a shame. Even though that's in my local gaming store recently shut down, it's all different story, and many weeks ago, and loads of particular stores, like pound stores, etc. So yeah, again, like I said, last week in general, quite a number of things have put me off last week in general, and it's just really put me off in terms of my, not saying routines of visiting town, but a slight change like that does affect me in some way, and I lately just been put me off a bit later than there's all the other stuff. But despite that, though, then is in certain video games, then is used video games, if that makes sense. Because knowing me, I do shop all around, knowing me, and I do love certain stores as I go to, because, I go to, Smith's and my supermarkets and Cash Converters, charity shops, cash generators and all that, and the CX as well. But, I shop all around. It's just a shame, a store like that's gone. And the reason why I would miss it daily, despite many, many years ago, Game Station, it's all a different story. When that's gone, I was easily moved on when it comes to Game Station, it's all a different story. But since Granger Games has gone, I'm sure I'll miss it for none of the geeky merch, the pre-owned stuff, and the new released house, all a different story. It's just the connection with the staff in general for quite some years, because I had some bad social problems myself, despite interacting with people, and it was nice to, interact with certain people in local stores. So I interact with some people in Smith's, then is somewhat in CX and some other stuff, but it just gets me something to do out of my day, despite being cooped in indoors. I try my very best to socialise, so really a whole different story. But you get what I'm trying to say, reasons why I kind of will miss Granger Games in general. Even though I edited a little something just yesterday, despite I didn't know if it was going to be my intro for this video, and decided to show you guys either way, because it was a bit long, 4 minutes long. But I want to show you this montage nonetheless, and you can see why I would kind of miss it, despite some really good memories, nonetheless, because I've been through all my YouTube videos that I recorded since then, and when I made this little montage, I had a bit of, not say, I didn't go, and the Waterworks All in Motion. I got quite a bit of emotion just yesterday when just going back in regards and not only just the story in general, but since the past few years alone and connected with the staff either way, and it's just been great. But nonetheless, though, despite I'm just getting old, trying not trigger is another thing, I'm trying not get emotional about it. But nonetheless, roll the VT. But I just want to quickly say, it's quite funny where I got this game from for £3. But basically, there was this new store that opened, well, a couple of weeks ago, but I just keep forgetting to mention it in my vlogs because I don't have the particular time to mention it. But basically, I went to this new store that was happening to my area, and it's called Granger Games. Because sometimes my Granger Games tend to import games for some reason, and I found this. And I kind of fingers crossed hoped if it works on my Xbox, but it works on my Xbox. But it's brilliant though, it came with additional, you know, arcade games, and it just saves me a bundle. You pre-order it in Granger Games, and that is, which is a UK store by the way. Basically you get this nice Wii U mug, and once you open it up, as you can see, it's got the Nintendo Wii U logo on the side, and puts a big U on the front of it. 40p odd short, basically I grabbed whatever that I had in my change, and basically had 2p's worth of 40 odd p, you know, sort of thing, and basically took all the way to Granger Games to try and get this game. And basically, long story short, I mentioned all this in the Tumblr blog, saves me rabbiting. But basically, and the person in Granger Games, who I don't particularly like, was close enough not to accept my change, and it was like, I'll accept your change, but make sure you don't do it again. So I traded it in, and basically I was expecting them to get £20 off, but instead though, I got £30 off, which is a bit odd, maybe because they were doing like a special discount, if he was trading in a controller for a controller or something like that, I don't know. But yeah, I can't complain. But so I got this for £15, so I'm actually pleased about that. The funny thing is though, during the morning when I picked up these certain things in Granger Games, and when I picked up these, I got a little something, because maybe because I got this, and maybe because it's nearly £100, let alone buying like a video game console and whatnot, and basically I actually got this, which is quite funny, I guess. Chat to the staff now and again. It's just that I think the manager said, I listened to your podcast and all that. I was like, are you talking about me? My videos and all that. I do vlogs, I do, let alone video logs. Speaking about Granger Games in general, when I actually picked this game up, I had a little chat with the staff members in Granger Games, and I've been given this, which I'm wearing, which is this. This is a Dark Souls 3 badge, and I can't say it. But however, which is very nice of Granger Games, which I'll show you guys that I got yesterday from them, because normally Granger Games, my local Granger Games, normally gives me nice stuff, and they gave me this. This past one in general, it has gone quite a bit better, and it's just leveled up so much, let alone trying to change my boundaries a bit and maybe, you know, trying to talk a bit more and all that. And it's been quite good, because, you know, I've been basically every time I go to my local store, I've been kind of chatting a bit more, especially my local Granger Games, if my local Granger Games is watching this, so thank you. For chatting with me and all that, and we have some real good conversations this past one year. Just like to thank you in general for talking with me and stuff, and we have conversations now and again. I was looking to save enough for the Switch and whatnot, but it was nice of Granger Games to give me some nice swag, so to say. So yeah, thank you Granger Games if you are watching this to this point. I was going to Granger Games, as I normally do, and because knowing the staff in Granger Games enjoys my content as is, I'd like to thank you guys nonetheless. And they just gave me this big bag, which I have here, and they just gave me some stuff, which is really nice of them. I'd like to thank you guys, because they gave me some stuff, because I do get some nice things from them in terms like, for example, pre-order leftovers they tend to give me, and recently the disassembled and got got rid of their poster stand, you see. So it makes sense, like, clearing out stuff, like I said, because they enjoy my content, and it's like the not saying the only guy, I you know, it makes sense to give stuff to me because I do love my gaming, so you know what I mean. But they gave me some posters. Like I said, they just dismantled their poster stand, so I guess they stopped selling posters as is. So they gave me a bunch of posters, which is nice of them. Again, I'm just really going to miss it entirely, and it's the staff in general. But I'd just like to say, regarding the staff, it's been a great store with all the pickups, new release stuff, as well as all the same pre-orders. This is the reason why I'm wearing my Samus Returns t-shirt today also, which again, I'm going to wear this as soon as Metroid Prime 4 comes out. But again, just them things in general that I enjoyed. It's kind of like a second home to me when GameStation was gone, despite all my other stores in general. And again, regards to my local gaming stores, all different story. I don't mind the staff in my local gaming store, despite somewhat mishaps with some of the staff. But either way, it's just Granger Games. Just felt like a second home for when GameStation left quite some years ago. But nonetheless, there's other stores to go to. I still got my Smiths for new release games, despite certain things which I mentioned about a bit that's pre-ordering. But anyways, I got my supermarkets and I got my second-hand stores like CEX, Cash Converters, etc. So there's still a variety of different stores, but it's just that connection with some of the staff in general, and you know, I've been having social problems, like I said, a little different thing. But nonetheless, you will be missed, Granger Games, nonetheless, and I just hope another gaming store, well, gaming retail store might hit the my local town centre. It's all different store. We'll have to see in what will replace it than is the certain stores in my gaming stores in my town centre, if that makes sense. So something will be replaced, and hopefully it'll be good, despite whatever I'm using at the moment. As it is, you know, with my weather stores that I have, because, you know, I still go around town, not just the town centre, but all around town, nonetheless. So there's a bit of gripe in my local area, and as it is, since all my certain stores in my local area have been going, I should say. But nonetheless, I'm alright, despite the changes that it has hit me quite hard. At least I've got some stores to go to that is staying indoors, all different store. I tried to go out, you know, socialising, getting active, so you know, that, this and that. So, what I've been up to this past 1 week, even in, like I said, on my last vlog, loads of things have been putting me off, despite this week, however, somewhat that is discovering that my local Grange Games is finally gone, I should say. But nonetheless, I've had an okay-ish week, even though that lately I've been saving up some money. As I said, a few vlogs back, I should say, because I've been planning to save up a certain amount of money, and despite it makes more sense why certain gaming retail stores has gone, because, you know, nowadays most people buy online, even though I'm guilty myself of buying stuff online, because I'm planning to get some certain stuff on Amazon than it is a certain Duke controller that I'm planning to pre-order at some point. But there is a Inside Xbox show happening next week regards on some Xbox original stuff that might be happening on the Xbox One, but nonetheless, I'm going to hold my fire. But I'm planning to get some credit either way, because I saved up enough to get a certain amount of credit, and I'm planning to get some Amazon credit either way. And after, when the Inside Xbox show happens, I might end up pre-ordering the Duke Control as well. Maybe get some Xbox original games. We'll have to see, because I'm holding my fire, because I've got certain things I might buy on Amazon. It's all different story. But again, it's my guilty pleasure, I should say, I'm buying stuff online. But it makes sense why certain retail stores are gone. There is certain retail stores that I still have, because I recently actually pre-ordered some in my local Smiths recently, because I thought I'd get around to pre-ordering it. And there's Dad of War, I should say. Well, God of War, but you know what I mean. I decided to pre-order God of War while the £5 off offer is still available, and I might as well take my chance on that and get this done. Good, but I got the other pre-order slip, you know, my Nintendo Labo, so I'm all good for this month. Then it's taken advantage with the £5 off offer, so another thing. But I think you get some pre-order bonuses for pre-ordering God of War, all different thing. But I'm looking forward to the game, even though I was unsure to get it at first, but might as well. Despite to my local not Asda's, Argos is doing like a, when you spend £50, you get an extra £5. And I recommend you guys doing that, for those people that are planning to get the game in Argos, because they're doing like the £5 gift voucher if you spend £50, all different story. But anyway, I just vocally mentioned about that either way. But despite certain game releases it is, I just hope this month entirely goes well. And even though I'm videos as it is, because I mentioned on my last vlog that I might be doing the one particular video per week, I should say. But I'll but briefly mention about something in regards to that. So yeah, what videos I'll be doing next week entirely. Because I was going to do one particular video next week, because Hellblade is coming out on Xbox One next week, and I was thinking of maybe getting it, because I got recently purchased some Xbox credit, not only to renew my Xbox Game Pass this month, but also I thought I'd get Hellblade, but I'm not so sure to get, despite whether they're on the same night, I should say, when the Inside Xbox thing, I didn't know to put some Xbox credit towards whatever they announce at the Inside Xbox show next week. But nonetheless, I'll see to end up playing Hellblade or for whatever for Wednesday. Then it is on the same day at the release of Hellblade, there is a what is it called? A RoboCraft tech thing, because it's planned to release next week, but it's also, if you have Xbox Game Pass, and some reason you can get to play for free, which is a bit odd. And despite, you know, like CFE's Day of Decay 2 and Crackdown 3, so I guess there's certain titles, once they're released, and you get to play via Xbox Game Pass. They have done that with Games of Gold, where basically if there's a certain indie game, I should say, they tend to release that along with being free with Games of Gold. But it's nice that we get a certain game, I guess it's an indie game, but you get to play with Xbox Game Pass. Well, on that though, I'm just looking forward to next week entirely, despite I might be just still doing the one particular video each week, despite next week I might do two. We'll have to see in terms of this month entirely. I just hope it'll be a good month all around. There's getting certain releases that I pre-ordered. Anyways, we'll leave it at that now. I'm sorry this video is a bit long, despite doing that little montage either way. But yeah, overall, so yeah, we'll leave it at that now. So that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying this vlog and watching the end of the stand. And hope you guys have a nice weekend nonetheless. Do not forget to follow up on my social medias warming up to. Anyways, I'll let you guys get on with your day. And yeah, I better go now. See you from CT Films.